Hey boyos, what's up? I've been thinking a lot about all these remakes and remasters that have been coming out recently. There's been so many good ones recently, like Resident Evil 2, The Crash Collection, Spyro, and maybe even sometimes it's a little unnecessary for these remakes. But I've been thinking about a few games from my past that I'd love to see with a fresh coat of paint, so here it is. A top 5 list. Top 5, baby! Number 1. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. The best-selling game of all time is Grand Theft Auto 5. We've all played it. We've all enjoyed it. That large sandbox open world. It's often chaotic online. But before GTA 5, there was a very long, storied past when it comes to Grand Theft Auto. Early in the game's franchise, it was a top-down action-adventure game. It still has the elements of GTA, I mean, it's in the title. You steal cars, you also shoot things from a top-down open-world perspective. GTA 2 was more of the same, and it wasn't even until GTA 3 where we got the GTA gameplay style that we all know today. That's when we were introduced to 3D graphics, a more dynamic world, and gameplay. A few games later, after some real classics, we got one of what I think is the most iconic GTA games, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. In this game, we get one of the best stories that GTA has to offer. Our protagonist CJ is returning home from Liberty City to his home turf of Los Santos and his former hood, Grove Street. With Sam Jackson kicking up the jams, and of course, one of the most iconic scenes of all time.
Carl, what do you want? You gotta eat to keep your strength up, man.
Hey, I'll take a number 9, fat boy.
Give me a number 9, just like his. Let me get a number 6 with extra dip.
I'll have 2 number 9s, a number 9 large, a number 6 with extra dip, a number 7, 2 number 45s, 1 with cheese, and a large soap.
This game introduced almost more RPG elements into GTA, where literally everything you do levels up a stat, making CJ a much better and stronger character. Meaning, if you drive a car a lot, you're gonna be better at driving. If you shoot a lot, you're going to be better at shooting that gun. You eat a lot, you're going to get fat. If you go to the gym a lot, you're going to get strong. It was so cool, man. I love that game. You may be asking yourself, this game seems fine. Why even remake it? You could play it on the PS4 already. Well, this game is hindered by its age, with frames popping in at random and the now ugly graphics. Look at those hands, man. Look at those hands. And one thing that legitimately pissed me off when I was recently replaying it was every time you fail a mission, there are no checkpoints. You just have to go back to the start of the mission to restart it. It's so incredibly frustrating, but I'd love to play that game with some modern intervention. Number 2. Jet Moto. Jet Moto is a game most people have forgotten about, but growing up I was a sucker for it. It was a futuristic racing game with a really interesting aesthetic for the PS1, made by the guys who made the Twisted Metal games. I love the look of the floating car, motorcycle things. It also allowed for some really interesting tracks. I grew up with Jet Moto 2, and boy, let me tell you, my feeble mind struggled with some of these tracks. With quick turns and strange platforming along with pure speed, it was a blast to play. I also didn't mind the Mountain Dew sponsorships either. Like a lot of PS1 games, these games are pretty dated. The polygonal look of the game and some of the textures look pretty gross in hindsight. The controls for this game are pretty bad feeling, but it would be amazing to have a game like this made in a modern era with upgraded graphics, better controls, and an actual story mode. Number 3. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 through 3. Doesn't it just sound amazing to have all of these games remastered in one big collection? These games were incredible, from the amazing soundtracks to all the crazy combos you could pull off. There was nothing quite like it. For me, these games really even put skateboarding on the map. There were tons of Tony Hawk games after these, some of them actually quite good in fact, but to me none of them really touched the magic of the originals. With the blunder that was Tony Hawk Pro Skater 5, it would be really nice to have these classic games remastered on modern consoles. Or we could just get a new skate game. That'd be cool too. Number 4. Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. In my opinion, the best Splinter Cell game in the entire series. The stealth and strategy of this game blew my mind when I first played it, and honestly looked pretty damn good for the time. Especially the lighting, which you actually had to take advantage of, not get spotted, so you could get to your next target. It'd be cool to get a new Splinter Cell game, but Ubisoft seems to be really dragging their feet, since we haven't seen Splinter Cell since 2013 with Blacklist, which honestly wasn't even really that well received. So why not just remake the classic and remind everyone why this is a franchise worth talking about. Number 5. Einhander. Admittedly, this is kind of a hidden gem of the PS1. I don't even really hear people talking about it these days, so this is a very biased pick on my behalf. But I loved this game as a kid. It's a bullet hell game, sort of Galaga-esque, but the visuals in this game were out of this world, especially for the time, and they still look good to this day. Also, this game is tough as nails. With the success of games like Resogun, it would totally make sense to have this game modernized. Jesus, it would be amazing to play on the Switch, man. Dude, I love the look of this game. All I'd want is them to up-res the game and re-release it in modern platforms. I'd be so happy. It'd be amazing. Well, that's my top 5 list for now of games that I'd like to see remastered. There's probably more games I'd like to see remastered, so maybe I'll come back to this. So, peace!